Please don't drive. Oh, look at that. It's nice. It feels like they're really getting on together. I know that's stupid, okay? But it's important that my Triceratops and my Piglet are best friends. And they go on wacky adventures together. That's all I want. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and we are back playing Minecraft Dinosaurs. And what you're looking at right now is a grave. This is the grave of the cave. It's the cave grave. As you see, if we knock this out a little bit, it's empty, I've cleared out. I've been busy, shall we say. This is probably the last time I'm going to do a big time jump between episodes. I think going forward, we'll have to see. I'm not going to promise that, but it's been about 3 hours of work. And I made a house. I built a house, and I did it all in survival mode. I was very proud of myself. I do have all of the footage still saved. It's about 2-2.5 hours worth of footage. I think what we'll do is a time lapse off that, but I'm not sure whether you guys have any interest in seeing that, so let me know in the comments. And if there is interest in it, I will showcase that in the next episode. I'll do like a little time lapse at the end of the next episode showing the house building process. The house is very ugly from the back. We're not allowed to look at the back. I will do something with this eventually. We'll develop it so it looks good from the back and front. And it's definitely not finished. This is a work in progress, to say the least. These little pillars at the front, for example, are eventually going to become a big overhang. But I want like a darker material to sit atop the rock. And I don't have anything that fits. But there you go. There's a house. It's alright. It's alright. It's not perfect. It needs a little bit of love. The glass is the problem. These glass panes break my heart. I so badly want to make them into clear glass, but the effort involved is extreme, shall we say. So that's definitely something for the future until we, whilst we're using survival mode, which is very much the continued plan, the glass is going to have to remain relatively ugly. But I'll give you a little tour, we'll head inside, and then we have to go see the Triceratops, because this took a few days, which of course means the Triceratops was growing. So the downstairs needs a little bit of love. The downstairs is pretty underdeveloped compared to the upstairs right now. It doesn't have any rooms or anything, it's just a big blob. And there's a pig, which is nice. There's also a block here. The block is annoying. Basically, and you might see this in the time lapse, at one point a golem decided to spawn within this floor of the house, and I went downstairs and it threw my house at me. It threw the blocks at me, as golems are prone to doing. And I killed it, and one of the blocks it threw kind of got stuck here, and I can't do anything about it. We can't iron pickaxe it, we can't replace it with blocks, we can run through it, and we can't kill it. I think I need to uninstall more creatures to get rid of it, but if anyone has any ideas, please let me know, because otherwise it's gonna stay there forever. We might have to build like a cabinet around it to hide the bloody thing. Let's nip upstairs, which I like a lot more. I think upstairs looks great at the moment. Everything is up here, as you can tell. Many, many things whirring away, but I think it looks really nice. If you ignore the many boxes, I think it looks great. I did spend more time up here on the detailing, just making it look better, like these little bits sticking out and stuff like that. We'll have to do that for the downstairs as well over time. But really, I just wanted to not live in a cave anymore. I really like this bit, this curved wall of glass that goes around the entire area. I do want a door here so you can walk out onto the front as well from the bedroom, but I can't because, again, no clear glass. I could use glass blocks, but they don't look great. So I want clear glass, and then we can put a door in there, and it'll kind of like disappear into the wall of the glass. It'll look really cool. So that's something for the future. As you can see, I've already done it here with stone instead. There you go. It's a good view, right? I realized one of my problems. I actually went back and took a look at one of my old Minecraft builds. I think the second ever Minecraft Dinosaurs we ever did, to see what kind of stuff I did. I think one of the problems we have here is this area is much more hilly. It's very up and downy, whereas last time we had this really nice flat area to work with, so we might be working on flattening quite a lot of this eventually, but we can work around the hills. We'll see what happens. A couple more things to show you. I want to grab some things. Oh, yes. Right. So first things first, I did grab some more fossils, boop, and we made our Therizinosaurus egg. Lovely stuff. Let's put those in there. And anything else? Right, I just want some tools. Do I want tools? I want some, actually, you know what I need? Some bloody sticks is what I need. There we go. And the furnace should be, I actually lost, you remember I had like 60 pieces of iron? I lost all of it. I was moving the stuff from the house, from the cave over to this house. Oh, that reminds me, I also accidentally need to change that. Let's just go on easy for now. I was moving the stuff from the cave over to the house, and I was on the last set of stuff, the very last set of stuff, when suddenly I got attacked by a creeper, and it blew up everything. I was like just about to go pick everything up, and the creeper emerged and blew itself up and killed about half the stuff I owned. So we did lose some. Hey, look at, oh, we got sturgeon. That's a strange choice. Okay, sturgeon. We could do like a little aquarium kind of thing. That'd be pretty cool. Right. So we need to make a couple more iron pickaxes. We need to make some. We need to make a lot of stuff. If I'm being honest, I did lose a lot. So let's stock up a little bit here. Put that away. Where's my? There it is. Right. So we're gonna make a couple of iron pick stone pickaxes to kick things off. Because you always want a stone pickaxe ready to. I have to do three of those actually. You always want a stone pickaxe. We're gonna want a iron shovel. We're gonna want an iron pickaxe. I think we're good. We're gonna call that good. We're gonna call that good. For now. And if we hop over here to this lovely box, you'll see that's the stuff that kind of survived. I made a couple new things, but generally speaking, I lost all the eggs, for example. We only have one snake egg left, which is very upsetting. And if we hop in here, we're gonna add that to our list. A Therizinosaurus egg done. And I thought people did mention this. Maybe we should go plant some of these old prehistoric plants within the Triceratops exhibit, because I think that'd be pretty cool. Speaking of which, plant fossils. Boop, boop. Right, one more thing to show you, and then I promise back to normality. Right, so I've got like a little thing down here. If we hop down here, boop, boop, boop. This again, very much in development. Also dark and spooky. That I think about this, I should definitely block this, shouldn't I? Like, things can just wander in at any point. I should do something about that, but whatever. And if we head out here, this area over here is what will become the lab. I had to rebuild this about 10 times until I got it right, but so it is kind of going to be a secret lab, but the front wall is going to be glass, so it's also not. If we could get one-way glass, that would be awesome. I'm pretty much 100% sure that's not a thing, but imagine you could look out from the lab and like see into the world and see into the Triceratops exhibit, which I am trying to hide in case you can tell. But they can see inwards. It looked like a hill. That'd be really cool. Let's go see the trike and also the little piglet who lives with the Triceratops, by the way. Yeah, this is why I want to save it. The Triceratops is officially humongous. Absolutely humongous. It took quite a few days to build all this, and like I said, I did do it in survival mode, so it was definitely slower. And the Triceratops had a lot of time to grow, you know? No. Oh. Do I need to do something with these to make them not rubbish? I guess so. Okay, we'll have to do a little bit of research into that. And all right, buddy, calm down. Bloody Nora. And the Triceratops still needs a name. I'm still looking for suggestions. Do let me know in the comments. And so does the piglet, because the piglet now lives here, don't you, buddy? Oh, right. I'll tell you what we need to do, folks. Tell you what we need to do. You find the bloody gates. What we need to do. There we go. We need to give our trike. Oh, hello. We can do this as well. We need to give our trike some, like a little water area as well, because I'm pretty confident it's no longer going to drown because it's freaking ginormous. So it definitely needs a way to get a drink. I don't know if that's even a thing, but you know, we want to look after our dinosaurs, right? We're also going to rebuild the farm today. One of the things I realized looking back at that old Minecraft dinosaur series I did all those years ago was things were a little less intense. You know, I'm going to chill a little bit with this series. Maybe some episodes are going to be a bit long and we're going to do some mining and stuff, but that's okay. I'm going to skip forward less going forward because people like hearing that kind of prattling nonsense. The house definitely needs some love. I like it as a basis, but it needs a bit of warmth to it. It's still got a bit more of a. It's a little bit monolithic in some ways, but I think it's a really good start. I want to do something with this, like this middle line here. I think we can pull this out and then make it into like a furnace kind of thing. Have like a fire here, kind of warming this area up. So when you're sitting out here, there'll be like tables and chairs here eventually. You can sit out here and keep warm. That sounds like a plan. Right. What are we doing then? What are we doing? Well, we're going to bed. We're going to stop talking in this accent now. Put the seeds and wheat away. Should have fed the Triceratops. Now that I think about it, put those away because they're rubbish. Check on our plant fossils. Hey, a bit more cactus green. Maybe not a big deal, but maybe a humongous deal at some point in the future, so worth keeping an eye on. Yeah, they don't go now. Everything is messed up, but there is still a system, and the system must be maintained. There we go. Let's go to bed. So, oh, I need to change vein miner. I forgot about that. What are we gonna do? Well, I'd like to start setting up for the Therizinosaurus. I've got a little bit of. I actually, again, went back and looked at one of my old exhibits, and I saw how I built it and stuff like that. And I saw some ideas I quite liked. Don't like that. Well, over there. and a creeper. I'm so tempted to stay on casual chicken mode. Oh yeah, I also got some gold. I don't really have anything to do with that right now. And another thing I really, really want is a little bit of glowstone. I have to go on a little bit of an adventure at some point and try to find some. Right, let's grab the carrots. Let's grab the beetroot seeds. Let's grab the normal seeds. Let's grab the sugarcane. We're going to set up a little bit of a farm. Beetroot seeds, and we need a hoe. Do I have my hoe? I have my hoe. One day she'll be my hoe no more, but for now she is my hoe. Oh, we need a bucket. That's what we need. We need a blooming bucket. 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 Where the hell's my bucket? Oh no, did it die? It might have died in the... Oh, no, there it is. I have no idea at this point what died in the creeper explosion. Many treasured things did not make it to the house. I hate you so much. Random block. I hate you. Many treasured things did not make it to the house. So let's have a little think about how we're going to plan this out. So I want the trike to stay there. Look at them running. It's adorable. This will, I think, continue to get expanded. I believe the trike is maybe... Can't be that far from fully grown, right? I mean, it's humongous. It is hu-freaking-mongous. It really is. So I'm hoping... I know, pal. I know. I even got the quills on. The quills are cool. You can actually... The quills are actually off by default, and I turned them on because I think they're awesome. Yikes. But I'm just trying to get a thumbnail. Please. There we go. Beautiful stuff. Oh, my God. It's trying to, like, sidewind me. How you doing, buddy? I know. I'm going to get you a drink as well. Don't worry. So... I need my shovel. And like I said, this first exhibit is going to be very rudimentary, shall we say. But we can start doing some fun designs for the next ones. I really want to try this Ferocinosaurus out. How are we going to do this? Just like a little... Yeah, we'll just make like a little pond shape. Are you going to drown if I do this? Maybe. It's a risk I kind of have to take, but it's not a risk I want to take. Let's nip over here. Okay, cool. I knew I could do that. I knew there was a combination where that worked. I just had to find it. Can you... Piggy! Good piggy. Like, I know you're just a pig. You're not even... You know, I don't own you, you're not tame to me or anything, but I care deeply about you, okay? Stupid little pig. God, please don't drown. Oh, look at that! It's nice. It feels like they're really getting on together. I know that's stupid, okay? But it's important that my Triceratops and my Piglet are best friends. And they go wacky adventures together. That's all I want. Any chance I'm going to be lucky enough to... Nope, not yet. Stay. Stay. Good piggy. We will eventually have a pig farm and stuff. I think we're going to build the farm... Oh, forgot about that. I think we'll build the farm area here. Exhibit there. Exhibit there, maybe? This might be a good place. Let's just have a little look. Maybe we could have a Therizinosaurus thing. If we flatten this area out a little bit with grass, so it's like this whole area is level, and then you'd kind of have like the house and a little exhibit here overlooking the Triceratops, which I swear has got even bigger in the last 2 seconds. And then the farm would be here. And then you could sort of go out further into the world from there. I like that idea. I want the Therizinosaurus to be fairly close. I think we also want to give it loads of trees. I don't know. This is that slightly awkward stage where I'm kind of like looking for suggestions and ideas from you guys as well at home. You know, what do we do next, basically? What do you think is... Mainly, what is the future of this park? You know, where do we go? What is the goal? What's the inspiration? What is the long-term idea behind what we're building here? That's better. There we go. I just need to get to the point where there's one that I can click. And it'll recharge, like so. Looking good? Looking good. Nice and level. Do I want to kill that? No, I kind of like that. There we go. A little bit of a pond. Nothing special, but it's something. Right, let's go work on the farm. Let's go work on the farm. Can you please get out of the way? Is it because you are huge! I swear you've grown. I swear you've grown. Do you need food? Do you want some carrots? There you go, buddy. There you go. I forgot the pigs are obsessed with carrots. Oh, what we can also do, people have mentioned, we can make like toys. Bag. We're such a bag. No. Ball? Rope? I can't remember what they are, but people mentioned that there's toys and something like you can use for your creatures. I don't know if that was a dinosaur thing though, rather than like a Mo creatures thing or a Zeus thing or an Animania thing. I don't know. Is there something that the dinosaur will interact with? Where's the fossils and archaeology stuff? Right, here we go. Here we go. So looking for anything in this area. So it ends there. Around here somewhere. Maybe we can plant the ferns. I don't know. I have no idea. So many creatures. Yeah, people do keep suggesting mods. You'll notice I haven't added any new mods since the last video. It's just because there's 38 prehistoric creatures in this game. 38, which is insane. Where's the sturgeon? And there it is. There's 38 prehistoric creatures, which is such an incredibly high number that to me, I don't really see the point in adding more creatures and more dinosaurs in particular at this point in time. It's definitely something we'll do in the future, but for now it seems just a little bit pointless to me, you know? Because we're nowhere near using all the creatures that are already in the game, never mind anything else. Why bother adding more, basically? In my opinion, so I super appreciate all the suggestions. I'm still checking all the suggestions out, but I do think we're gonna. Oh, it is a ball. Oh, sweet. Okay. How do we make a ball? Okay, how do we make a ball? we need a slime ball, which I don't believe we have. A white ball and bone meal makes a white ball. That's very exciting. So we need 4 pieces of wool, 4 pieces of string. We need a slime ball. To get a slime ball, we need a green slime block. To get a green slime block, we need slime balls. To get a congeal, we need slime. It just goes on. We haven't got any slime balls yet, so we can't do that yet. Is there any more by any chance? That's exotic birds. Doesn't look like it. I'm missing something. Somebody told me there's quite a lot. I'm only seeing balls. It's just like real life all over again. Oh, scratching post. Sweet. Well, hey, we might be able to do this. Should we make a scratching post? I think that's a really cool idea. Would a Triceratops want? Or a tethered log, maybe? We could plant a tr I don't know how the tethered log works. Too soon. Right, we're gonna go for both of those. Let's get some cool stuff for our trike, but we'll quickly work on the farm while we're here. So basically, what I want is to plant on all my resources to be basically the same shape, if that makes sense. You know what we need, folks. You know what we need. I'm very sorry about this. We need some dirt. We need lots and lots of dirt. Where's my shovel? We'll use a good one. We'll speed it up. But we do. All we need is dirt. I need an area that's dirtier than this. I know we need the dirt, but we also need to keep this looking like a mountain, if that makes sense. So we cover it up. We gained dirt, but not enough. Let's head out into the wilderness a little bit. Dirt is oddly difficult. It's not difficult to get. We just need to. I want to get dirty without ruining the mountain. You know what I mean? I like the mountain to still look like a big, dirty mountain. I'm gonna stop saying dirty, but I know what I mean, right? If we dig down to here though, then we can kind of dig around all the sides, and it's not gonna impact how the mountain looks. But we need some dirt. Gonna get dirty. So we're not allowed that piece. Some dirt is off limits, okay? You need the good dirt, solid. Well, not solid dirt. That'd be weird. You can make mud somehow as well. The pigs in this game adore mud. And I feel like the Triceratops would as well. I feel like a Triceratops as a dinosaur might appreciate a bit. Getting a little dirty, you know? I mean, who doesn't, right? Nerds, that's who. But yeah, I've been thinking a lot about this and looking at my old playthroughs and stuff. I think we are gonna just chill a little bit. I don't regret like doing all the house stuff because honestly, it took so bloody long, and I'm still happy to show you that footage. And I think we definitely did mid-video, like in between video stuff in the last series. But I don't know. It's a kind of game that suits being relaxed and chill and digging and mining. And every episode is not going to be a brand new dinosaur, you know? Especially if we want this to last. That's the key more than anything else, I think. If we want this to be a long-running series, which I really do, we can't expect every episode to be a blockbuster new dinosaur and a blockbuster new thing happening, you know? Sometimes it's going to be just building a farm. looking after temporarily Trevor, as he's my triceratops is called, because I can't think of a name and I don't have one yet. And his name isn't Trevor, it's temporarily Trevor, as in his first name is temporarily. What the back? Yeah. There we go. Got some dirt on. This is like an island, isn't it? I think we're how close by water, are we? Yeah, fairly. Oh, there's a little snowy area over there. That might be pretty cool to go explore sometime. Right. Let's knit back over here. We're going to have to kill this at some point, but I'm a little worried the water will just go everywhere. I really do like parts of this house. I think we need windows downstairs. That's something we'll do when we go inside. But what I want to do right now is move over here towards the farm, and we just want to extend this area out. There's just not enough room right now. And the quicker we put the dirt down, the more likely it is to turn to lovely looking grass by the time the morning. By the time the morning hits, basically. This bit here is the bit that I've missed having creative mode on. Just doing this kind of stuff. But it's Minecraft. We're crafting and mining and blah, 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 blah. I regret throwing away all that dirt in my time. I've thrown away so much dirt. But we... Oh! Yep, okay. Hi, buddy. I'll come back in the morning. Yeah, that was terrifying. No interest. Hard pass on that. Thank you very much. Good night. Bloody no. Do we have any dirt? No. Well, that was terrifying. I don't really know what to say. That was freaking terrifying. Bloody Nora. Whew. I can't imagine it's fun turning into a werewolf. I think I should murder him. Sounds mean, but I mean, if you were a werewolf and you want to get murdered. Maybe. This is on easy mode, and I've got werewolves and manticores on my doorstep. Do you want me to kill you? Nod for yes. There you go. I'm sorry, pal. Well, am I? Yeah. You know, it is what it is. It's a freaking werewolf. Actually, I used to have massive nightmares about werewolves. I really like werewolves in general, and they don't scare me, like, as a thing. Like, nowadays, werewolves are not that scary to me, obviously, because whatever. But when I was a kid, when I was probably 10 years old or something like that, I remember buying this book. It was this book about werewolves, and it was like it's just a story about werewolves with very graphic illustrations. Like, if my mum had actually looked at the book before I bought it, she would not have let me have it, let's put it that way. And my mum let me do pretty much whatever the hell I wanted, so it was brutal looking. I can picture this, I think this guy was like in front of a car. It's like old-timey Victorian London or something like that. What the hell, is that a maggot? Yeah, no. No. Not happening. Hey, we got slime! All part of my master plan, you see? All part of my master plan. Anyways, I used to have massive nightmares after reading this werewolf book because it was so brutally graphic in design, and I used to just have this recurring nightmare where I would wake up in the middle of the night and there was a werewolf looking down at me, like from above, and then they would tear into me and kill me, and then I'd wake up. That was like the whole dream, basically. Let's have a little look at this. It's not enough room, is it? No, I think we just need to keep extending this area out. I want a barn. I don't know why I've got this. It's like a big red barn, like sitting there. It's become an obsession for me. And we're gonna wait on the Ferrocinosaurus because I'd love some ideas from you guys at home, basically. What do you think we should do for the Ferrocinosaurus exhibit? I've got a couple of ideas, but I'm open to suggestions. Something that is realistic would be nice. You know, we are still somewhat limited at this point in time in what we can do. We're on survival mode, and we're on episode 4, so we are limited. And I went back and checked again the old series. I think it took 10 episodes or something to get our first dinosaur, so we're already making really good progress in this playthrough, I think. Hello. Oh, there's a mod called Forestry. It's on my future mod list. We're not going to get it yet. Why am I going all the way over here? I don't care. But we are going to get it in the future. Because it adds like a whole apiary system. Apiary is how you use bees and stuff, right? make an apiary. And it's a proper detailed system where your bees will get you rewards and different things, and you can upgrade your apiary, and what the bees get you upgrades, and it's like this really incredibly complex bee mechanic, and it sounds really cool. That's the kind of thing I want in the future. We don't want to worry about making an apiary right now. It's like we're not even worrying about the pigs and stuff right now, but it's definitely something we'll be working on down the line as we develop the whole area, because it's not just about the dinosaurs, it's about having the whole thing feel like a real... Like, we crash-landed on this planet, we're trying to survive, we built ourselves a house, which I think is, you know, a fairly normal thing to do. Maybe you wouldn't build yourselves a big modern art-esque house, but you'd build a house, and then you start discovering these dinosaur fossils, and maybe you'd build, like, a simple little Triceratops exhibit. You wouldn't build anything too fancy, but you would definitely start to experiment. Well, we would, you know, dinosaur fans would start to experiment. And then naturally over time you start to worry and adapt and build more stuff and build a bigger farm and bring in new creatures and things develop from there. And at this moment I don't know what the plan is. I'm really, really open to suggestions. What you guys think we should do? You know, what is... Are we building a zoo? Are we building a park? Are we building just a... Like a... Whatchamacallit, like a sanctuary kind of thing where we look after these creatures and maybe release them into the wild eventually. That'd be quite cool, I think, in a way. It'd be upsetting, and that's kind of half the point. You know, we develop a bond with this Triceratops over time, and then on episode 20 or something, we let it go into the wild to be with its kind, or we breed like a breeding pair, and we get a few of them going, and we kind of... Because these dinosaurs don't exist in the wild. Most, like, the vast majority of creatures on this mod don't exist in the wild. I think there's like 3 or 4 exceptions total. So maybe our goal is to kind of reintroduce them into the world via breeding pairs and stuff like that. I think that's quite a cool idea. We can become like an eco-warrior sort of thing. And that means we want to live off the land, we want to have pigs, we want to have cows. We want to have sheep. We want to have all that. But yeah, I'm really open to suggestions. I don't really have any grand plans for where we're going with this. I just really wanted to play with the mod. And I really wanted to spend half my day digging in dirt. So, you know... How are we doing on dirt? That should be enough. Need some food as well. Probably gonna have to murder some more pigs. It's fine being an eco-warrior and murdering pigs. That's not hypocritical. People always think that's hypocritical. It's not. You can definitely care about the world and the environment and still want to eat delicious, delicious animals. Well, I do anyway. I want both worlds. I love meat far too much. What people forget quite a lot is how there's a lot of animals out there that would not exist as much if they weren't useful, shall we say. And it's all well and good saying, oh yeah, you should protect all the animals no matter what, but money doesn't come from nowhere. I really want to build a... Can you build like a tomb? Tomb. Grave. Graveyard soil heals undead. Wow. We could build a proper... I'm going to have to get a mod that installs a gravestone. And we'll build... We'll have a little ghost on there. And then we can do that every time like one of our animals dies. We can have a little tomb. Sounds terrifying. I really want a tomb now. I want like a mausoleum as well. Like at the back of it. And we can make it proper haunted and stuff. Where's my Triceratops? It's so huge. I just assume I'll be able to see it from every single angle. But no. Why do I want that so badly now? It's like proper in my head. Like I need that to happen. I want like a really spooky looking area. I'm going to find a mod that lets me add like a fog machine or something. Yeah, that's... If anyone knows any good weather mods, actually, that'd be really cool. Like, so we get some more dramatic weather. I don't know if that's a thing, but for 1.12.2. I'm pretty happy with the stuff in the world. There's not really that much I want to add. People do keep leaving suggestions, and there's nothing that's really grabbed me yet. One in particular is the... Oh my god, I gotta stop doing that. It's like the eclipse of the... dinosaurs or something like that. I can't quite remember the name, but it's a great looking mod. It has tons of dinosaurs, but we don't need tons of dinosaurs right now. It's definitely something for the future rather than right now. And it is definitely something we'll consider down the line, don't get me wrong. I don't see the point in doing it right. Stop that. I don't see the point in doing it right now. Which I hope makes sense to you lovely folks at home. Oh, thank you guys in general. Like, people are really eager about this series. Every time I play any other game, every comment I get is, where's Minecraft Dinosaurs? Like, so, to give you guys an idea, the schedule should be 3 episodes of Minecraft Dinosaurs a week. Roughly. It should be every other day, and I don't work on Sundays generally. Sometimes I do, but typically I won't work on Sundays. So usually every other day, Minecraft Dinosaurs, every other day, Jurassic World Evolution, and then we'll do bonus videos of other stuff. I think that's kind of the idea in my head. I don't want to commit to it fully because life does get in the way, university gets in the way, stuff like that. But the idea should be every other day is Minecraft Dinosaurs or Jurassic World Evolution, and then we do other videos on top of that as a second video a day. So if something new comes out, we'll do that. If the Isle updates, we'll do that. Blah, 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 blah. Now, that only works until something new comes out that I don't want to play all the time. Say, Prehistoric Kingdom. Say, Jurassic World Evolution updates. Things will change temporarily for that as well. Hopefully that makes sense. But you should expect 3 episodes a week on average. So there you go. And it should be roughly every other day. Hopefully that helps. You eager beavers. Which I love, I really do. Even when it's just this, hopefully. Just shoving down dirt. This is necessary groundwork. I don't want to put all of it not in video because then every time you come on, it's like the world has changed so much. Like already it's changed a bit too much with the house, which looks great from here. It's very modern art, and I hate modern art. But I don't want it so that you guys don't really know what's going on, you know, so that the series is impossible to keep track with just because every time a new episode comes on, the world has changed so much. So I'm going to try to avoid that going forward. There we go. Much, much, much more room. Lovely stuff. Right. So. I didn't. Oh, okay. Now, if I remember correctly, one blob extends to 4 squares of water, is it? Something like that? Okay, I've just had a little thought as well. If I plant some seeds in the Triceratops exhibit, I love that sleepy piggy. Will the Triceratops eat the seeds and therefore, well, eat the wheat and therefore auto replenish the seeds kind of thing? Basically, can we make it so that if we plant enough of it, we don't have to keep going back and feeding the dinosaur? Is that a thing? I know we can make feeders, which is definitely an alternate idea. Because that's not that difficult to make. And we can actually put the feeder in the ground and kind of hide it, which is pretty cool as well. I don't know. Yeah, we can build a feeder. Let's build a feeder. We'll build a feeder. That sounds like a plan. So, for a feeder, we need glass. How much glass? One piece of glass. One piece of glass. Does normal glass work? I have to assume it does. We need a bucket, so we need 3 pieces of iron. We need 5 pieces of iron. We need 4 pieces of stone. That's andesite. And we also need a button, which requires a piece of stone. So we need 5 pieces of stone. Okay, and we need 5 pieces of iron. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should, in theory, work out fine. In theory. There's always a theory. It never works out well. Was I doing it? Sifting? No. Analyzing? No. This? Yes. Iron. Beautiful, beautiful iron. Oh, it's so nice after having lost all of it. Right, so first things first, button. And then we need a bucket. I put all the iron away, didn't I? Yep, absolutely all of it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. Oopsie daisy. So we need bucket. Bucket. And then let me see if I can remember this off the top of my head, right? So that goes. I've already forgotten. No, I can remember. I can remember. That goes there, that goes there. That goes there. This is wrong, isn't it? Think that goes there? Eh? Oh, I'm pretty proud of that. Considering I don't have a functioning memory, that's pretty good. Right, got ourselves a little feeder, so we'll go put this in. I believe we can put this underground, not underground, but so that the top of it kind of just about shows above ground, so that you don't have to have it as a block kind of just sitting there. So this should look better. Let's try that out. We'll put it near the water. So just over here. Feeder. And then put in some carrots. Okay. And we'll keep an eye on that. I'm not. I think that works. I'm pretty sure that works. Don't eat the carrots. Don't eat the carrots. We'll see if it goes down. What was it on? I need to make sure the pig doesn't. Oh no. We do need to make sure the pig's not eating it, otherwise this system doesn't work. Right, it's on 315. We'll come back later and see. The pig should not be able to use it. I'm sure that's not coded. So 315. We'll come back later. We'll see if that's gone down at all. Right. So farm. I'm not going to make this 100% efficient because A. Well, only because A. I kind of like my stuff to look better. You know, this is a visual game in a lot of ways. So what I do want to do is have four different crops, right? So we're going to do it in an X shape. Right, okay, let's just start. I'm just going to put a block in. Yeah, there we go. That's the middle, right? And then the idea is it'll come out and across from there, and you'll have four different square shape of crops. There, 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 there. I kind of want it over here, though. I need more dirt. I actually need just a little, not much, we just need a little bit more dirt. Just a little bit. I mean, enough dirt. Can you ever have enough dirt in your life, though? Nice. So many philosophical questions to answer today. Deep stuff, folks. Deep stuff. Right, that'll do. That is plenty, though. And we can block that in as well. Lovely stuff. Right, so we're gonna block in our farm, which is sad. Let's kill all the crops. Pew 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 pew. Sorry. If I block in the water, that should kill this as well. Right? We'll speed up the process. Kill your babies. Well, kill your darlings is a very well-known saying. It just means it's a literary term primarily. I guess it works in film as well. Just basically build characters you love and then put them through absolute goddamn hell. That's the idea, basically. Because that's what makes for compelling storytelling. I really want this, but it's in a terrible position. We're gonna have to just quickly build an alternate well. It'd be nice to build like a proper well as well, wouldn't it? Like a wellity well. I don't know what a wellity well is, but it's something. It's a thing. Don't judge me. Don't Google it. It'd be nice to have a proper well. Can you have proper wells? Maybe there's a mod for it where we can have, you know, like a bucket that we send down into the bottom of the well, and maybe a child can get stuck down there, and I'll send a dog in. I don't know where I'll get a child or a dog, but that would be cool, right? I think that's the dream. Is that the dream? It's a weird dream. There we go. Right. Rip. Should have made another shovel. Oh, so should have made another shovel. Shovels are annoying. You go through them really quickly. So this is where we're gonna build the farm. You. Thank you. You showed me the way of the hole. Usually I have people for that. Wow. Okay, so got my shovel out. Got my shovel out. We're gonna build a little cross section there. That's gonna be the barn, animals, or maybe the barn further back. Animals there, wheat there, stuff there. Triceratops there, Pherizinosaurus there. Is this flattened? No, we'll have to flatten this. So this is going to go straight across. This will be a drop, and we'll put like a little staircase in here as well. And because I like to put stone everywhere, it's like a little path. So let's definitely start working on that. Okay, so in the middle, about here. Then we want to go this one, two, three, four, five, six, I guess. One, two. Three, four, five, six. Really wish I made another shovel. One, two, six, seven. Let me just go the same number in this direction as well. I just think it'll look cool. It's not going to be that efficient, and we're going to have to add more water in, I believe. But it'll look cool, maybe. It might look terrible. Who knows? That's the fun. Right. Let's have a little look from above. I mean, I don't think we need more than that right now, right? That's going to be a lot of crops. I'm going to extend it out by one. I want it to be big and impressive, but we can always extend it as need be. And we actually don't even have four crops right now. We only have three: beetroot, carrots, and wheat. So, let's grab the water next. Boop, little well. This might take a minute, but we'll get there. Hopefully, we get to the point where we can do this as well. Actually, tell you what we should do. Tell you what we should do. If we knock this out in the middle, like so, A, it looks a little bit cooler, but B, maybe it'll create more like a sustainable water source, which is what we're looking for. Clearly need a little bit more. But I think we should be able to take from this middle section once this has been built up a little bit, and that's going to speed up the whole process. So I don't have to do this whole 2 second run I'm having to do here, which is just. Phew! Hey, look at that bad boy. Beautiful stuff. Right, let's get it nice and moist. I haven't really been bothered by the word moist as much as some people. It's not my favorite word. I'm not gonna write home about it. I'm not gonna ask somebody if they're moist, for example, because that's just freaking weird. But yeah, it doesn't freak me out. I'm pretty sure people only started saying it freaks them out because of How I Met Your Mother, to be honest. We're very much influenced by media more than we think we are. That includes YouTube channels. I'm influencing you all right now to try to get you to join my cult. You don't realize, even though I've told you, it doesn't matter. I'm still gonna join. I don't know what the cult's about, but hopefully you'd all join. I think that would be nice. Right, there we go. There's my cross of water for science reasons. Shut up, don't judge me. Okay, where is my hoe? There's my hoe. Got my hoe. Eh? Hate grass. You should be damper quicker than you are. Well, it'll be fine. It's not damp yet, but it is literally connected to the water. There's no reason it wouldn't be damp, right? And yet it's still not damp, and I'm very curious why. Is it because I'm running all over it? No, that's not a thing. It'll get there. It'll get there. So that's our wheat, and we'll develop that further as well. Let's plant some carrots because carrots are cool. Can we plant carrots? Is that a thing? It is a thing. Awesome. Am I missing something as to why some of that isn't working? Is it just taking a little bit of time? It must be, right? It's literally connected to the water. Why would it not instantly work? Grumble, grumble. There we go. There we go. Yeah, so some of it takes a little. Did I run out of carrots? I ran out of carrots. Okay, and that means we'll run out of beetroots as well, but we'll plant the 10 seeds we have. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. A little farm. Eventually, we'll cover it all in, like, we'll cover the outside in stone and kind of set it off. But I think that's pretty cool. I'm not sure how deep. I think it's going to be an awesome looking shape by the end of it, though, which is important. So we'll have some stone that comes out from here, down here, to the Ferrocinosaurus, down here to the farm, down there to the Triceratops. Yeah, pretty successful, I think. So, next episode, ladles and gentle spoons. Let's put some lights over here for now. Stop the blimmin'. We need to protect from rabbits. Delete my carrots. It's actually a concern. Next episode then. I'd like to. We'll keep working on this farming little area as well. I do want a barn. I do also want like a pen. Maybe try to get some pigs and stuff. But I don't think we're ready for the trough and all that kind of jazz. We're gonna make a ball. Can we make a ball? How many slime balls did we need to make a ball? I think it was three. No. Oh, just one. Okay, so next episode, we're gonna make a ball. We're gonna dye it so we can play with our Triceratops a little bit. We'll make some scratching posts and all that kind of stuff. I think we're gonna plant some trees in there as well. I think the exhibit is actually too small again. I did actually extend it. I don't know if you noticed, about 4 blocks this way towards where the lab is, but I think we need to bring it to the left by about 4 blocks and to the right by a little bit. There is a little bit of a chasm over there, but we can have the edge of the Triceratops look over the chasm, which would be pretty cool, I think. So we're gonna extend that even further out in basically all directions. We're gonna work on the farm. We're gonna try to design a little Therizinosaurus exhibit right here. It's gonna have to be fairly big because it's a big dino, but we'll flatten from probably knock this down and then have you drop down by 1 block into this area where you'll build the Therizinosaurus exhibit. Yeah, it's come together. Little things like having that honestly make a big deal to me, like how I view the whole thing. I think it's really important to. I see you. You there. Why would that. Why? 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 Everything else seems okay. They're not all there. This one's not taken either. Oh no, what is going on here? What possible reason is there for not. It's literally next to the water. Oh, whatever. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. We've got a big chunky triceratops. We've got a lovely-ish house. It needs a little bit of love, but we'll keep working on this bit by bit. I do want to make this overhang, but I still don't know the material. I want something dark. I think it needs like a really dark color to kind of contrast against all the light stone. Oh, and it's raining. Well, that'll be good for the crops. But we are going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentle ladies. I will see you lovely folks in the next episode. Please tell me what the hell to do about this. I might work a little bit down here. I don't know what we're gonna do. Like, I'm gonna install the furniture mod as well because we want to build like tables and stuff here. We want this to be a, we want it to feel like a living room, and then maybe have a kitchen here, and have like an open plan kitchen, dining room, living room sort of area. It should feel like a house. It should feel like a home. I need to move all the blocks down into the lab, but the lab isn't ready yet, so temporarily they can all stay in the bedroom. And we need to worry about clear glass, but that'll come down the line. Right, there we go. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love. As always, if you did enjoy this video and you want to see more Minecraft dinosaurs, which I know a lot of you do, please do hit the like button and let me know in the comments as well, because it really helps me out. It just lets me know you guys are enjoying it, which is the entire bloody point at the end of the day. So, yeah, that's about it. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.